Hi, this is Martin Drummond with Progressive News. It's Sunday, July 14th, 2019. And today I'm going to talk to you about yet another reason why capitalism sucks. In fact, I'm going to teach you, and I don't care if you are the dean of the Harvard Law School, you don't know this. And it's been right in front of your face. You know what they talk about, hiding in plain sight? Well, this is it. This is how they do it. So, you know, we hear a lot of talk about the monetary system, about modern monetary theory, MMT, and all this, you know, and quite frankly, you don't have to be educated, you just have to be interested to figure these things out, and it's all nonsense. I mean, everybody has their own silly ideas, but they can't really encompass the world and the model of the world properly to understand it. So I'm going to what I do is I take you through one thing at a time, and I'm going to explain to you one way, very important way, that the monetary system is just flat out evil. Okay, and that's pretty simple. And a lot of you will say, oh well, I knew that, but nobody ever seems to bring it up. I watch all the greatest economists, and nobody seems to bring this up. And that is simply that money is the way that the rich people distribute privilege throughout the wealthier part of the system, say the top one third of the pyramid. So the way they do it is simple. If you're rich, and this is it, this is the crux of what I'm talking about in the system, okay? And that is that if you have lots of money, so if they pick you, and they pick you, the way you know somebody was picked is they have lots of money, okay? It's quite simple. Now, I'm not saying that it doesn't wishy-wash around and money doesn't get in the hands of other people, but trust me, the way they control it is very succinct. They know exactly what they're doing, and they make sure that the people who they like, even though some people they don't like will get money, I'm not saying they will, they have other ways of controlling those people. But they make sure that they get the money, the ones that they want to have the money, and that's how they reward them for being loyal to the capitalist system. And the way that works is that if you have lots of money, and if you know you can get more money, then the fact that something's more expensive doesn't matter to you. I mean, if you're making $25,000 a year and you want to buy a $25,000 car, that's a huge deal for you. But if you're making $250,000 a year, and you know that because you're in the system, right, you're what did George Carlin call it, you know, being a member of the club. If you know you're a member of the club, then you can drop that $25,000 like it didn't even exist, like you didn't even have it. Because in a way, the way that the system works, the way that they set it up to reward their club members, is that money doesn't matter. I mean, if you have a lot of it, it just doesn't matter anymore. You know, it matters a lot to somebody with no money, or very little money. So that's how they do it. I mean, that's pretty simple. And it's counterintuitive, right? I mean, it's not something that you could pick up on. You have to think backwards and then apply logic in order to figure out that's exactly what they're doing. That's exactly what their club works. And it works inversely, too, because if you don't have very much money, if they make sure that you don't have a lot of money, then if all of a sudden you have a lot of money, believe me, they're going to look at you, right? Are you a drug dealer? Are you one of their drug dealers? Because, you know, if you're one of their drug dealers, then that's okay, right? If you're a big wigs who's smuggling money or smuggling cocaine, say, into the country for them through their Colombian cartels, then, you know, and why is it all the way, just to get off subject for a second, why is it always Colombian cartels? I mean, the massive amounts of cocaine are produced in Bolivia and everywhere else, but Colombian and now to a lesser extent Mexican cartels are always in control of it. Gee, could it be because the United States has invested a huge amount of money and the rich people are down there? Is it? Could it be that the American banks are well known to have laundered the money for the Colombian cartels? You know, see what I'm saying? Could it be because American rich people are the real people smuggling cocaine into the country? Oh yeah, they get everybody else to do it for them, and they create enough distance for so that they can't get, so that if the stuff is caught coming into the country,
basically, in a nutshell, I think I covered it all yesterday when I was recording this. They have thoroughly brainwashed America and the world, capitalists have, into believing that the monetary system is just some great thing that came along. In reality, we don't even need it. We could simply go around and talk to people and find out what they need, and arrange for companies to produce it and supply it, and arrange for scientists to figure out how the best way, and researchers, research and development, what have you, to produce it, and people could just get it delivered to them every, you know, maybe two or three times a month or whatever they needed. Obviously for perishables you'd need delivered, but you know what, when I was a kid almost everybody got their milk delivered to them. I mean, imagine that. I mean, now we don't even worry about our wives getting nailed because there are no milkmen. So, you know, I mean, really, when it comes right down to it, we don't really need money. But it has its uses, I suppose, and it could have its uses. I mean, we could still use it for the luxury goods, right? Because luxury goods aren't going to be covered under any system. Or we can use it. We can use money to do this. But like everything else in this capitalist system, it's corrupted. It's used to punish people who are disloyal to the capitalists. It's used to reward people who are loyal. That's how they own our political system. And once again, I want to reiterate that I am not for taking anything away from rich people or well-to-do people. I say we, in fact, guarantee them their wealth. I say that we guarantee them in perpetuity, is that the right word? Forever, their wealth. I know that sounds crazy, but I've looked at the numbers, man. We could buy them up off for next to nothing. I mean, all we would give them is their fancy educations and their trips to the Swiss Alps to go skiing in the winter or whatever, and their, you know, hanging out on the French Riviera and their fancy hotels and all that kind of stuff. A couple of houses, you know,
A few of them would get a lot, you know, a plane and a boat and all that stuff. But believe me, it's a drop in the bucket. A drop in the bucket. And we guarantee it to them and their family forever. And the catch, though, is that they would not be allowed to ever participate in politics, the political system, or the economic system. So all their companies would revert over to the government, which would very handily, like Medicaid and Medicare, with them out of it, with the rich people out of it, it'll run great. The problem with Medicaid and Medicare now is that the rich people have their claws into it already. They make all the money. I mean, we think of Medicare and Medicaid as being something that makes sure that people, you know, poor people and stuff get good health care. Well, that may be true, but it comes at a huge cost, and that is that all those poor people go to a, you know, unless it's a county health clinic or a, and even then, there's private, it all goes to private, you know, privately owned health care. It all goes to the rich. So, you know, we're going to have to fix all that. I know I've already done a segment on that, but you guys don't watch it, so I'm just going to repeat the same things over and over again until you guys actually watch my stuff, and then you'll just have to hear it over and over again. We're going to have to get the money out of the healthcare system. We're going to have to get the money out of the new systems we set up to provide people with housing, people with education. I mean, it's not going to do us any good to produce all these different agencies that, yeah, sure, they do things for people that weren't taken care of before, but all the money goes to the rich people. What's the fucking point, man? What's the fucking point? Do you not see the dichotomy here? We're even progressives, you know, I always have problems with everybody because people don't see things. You have to see this. We do not want the rich making tons and tons of money off of our systems to provide health care, to provide housing, to provide education, whatever. The stuff that people need. You know, I think it's really sick, too, that the capitalist system doesn't even protect a person's ability to get a job. I mean, you have to have a car to get to work, right? But, so why isn't car insurance like health insurance? If you're poor, you get it for free through the government, like health care. You know, I'm not saying it's immediately it should be free to everybody, but why not make it free to people who can't afford it so that they can get in their cars and go too? I mean, it'd be a boom for the gas companies, right? They'd all be getting new customers who buy gas, and for that matter, provide them with gas for free. You know, after they're making a lot of money from because they're back at work, then they won't be able to qualify for it at some point, right? The enticement to move into that higher bracket will remove them from the system that provides them with free stuff. I mean, that's how it should work anyway, right? We could at least move to that system. I mean, I see us eventually as being like in Star Trek, where nobody has to worry about anything. They get everything they want. Because then you know that they're participating because they have faith in the system, right? Okay, so anyway, capitalist system uses money to punish the people who are disloyal, to reward those who are loyal. This is Martin Drummond with Progressive News. Thanks for watching.